Welcome to the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report, hosted by Craig Dawson, Vice President, Soul Pit Media.
Hello, and welcome to the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report. We are here today with Michael and Lateresa Blackwell, owners of Cafe on the Corner. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Craig, for having us. It is a pleasure to be here, and we're truly humbled for this opportunity.
Thank you so much. I've really been looking forward to this interview, and I wanted to ask you, how long have you been in the restaurant business?
I've been in the restaurant business a total of 51 years.
Wow. Makes me feel young again.
Yes, sir.
Now, is this something that you had always envisioned as a career?
Well, I'll tell you one thing, Craig. It started when I was 17 years old. I was a pot washer in the Allegheny Club in South River Stadium. Again, I was 17 years old. And an opportunity came through Local Union 237 that offered an apprenticeship to cook. Prior to that, I had dropped out of school. I wasn't headed anywhere. And out of 200 employees, I was chosen for the apprenticeship program. Mind you, all of my co-workers were all white, which was over 200, and I was the only Black. And they said that I was the best worker, and they chose me, and that began my career.
Wow, that is phenomenal. And it also gives our youth something to, you know, look forward to. It's not where you start, but it's where you end.
Yes, sir.
Now, you guys are truly a family business with both you and your wife working together. How do you blend a home life and a business life together?
Well, I tell you, you know, starting out in the business, it's you're finding your way through. You're trying to figure out where you fit in. And sometimes you cross over where you're not supposed to. You cross your boundaries because you're trying to find your way in the business. And once we discovered where each person is and our strength lies, we discovered my husband is the production. He does and handles the production of the business. So he's all hands and feet on with the business. And I discover that I'm more of the administrative side. So I set up the networking, and we vowed that we would do business during business hours. And when business hours are over, we come home and we keep business where business is supposed to be. And we respect that. And then we've also learned that all work and no play is good for anybody. And so my husband and I have dedicated that we would leave the business behind at least twice a year, and we go on vacation for some well-deserved R&R. And we've been doing that for 7 years, and it's been working. It wasn't always like this. You know, like I said, we stumbled, but we figured it out, and now we're on a road of just restoration and rest and enjoying one another.
That sounds like an excellent blueprint to not only have a successful business, but a successful marriage. Now, while doing research for the show, I actually read that in your mission statement that you truly want to make a difference in the community. Can you tell us how you feel that hiring from a community strengthens the community?
Because we live here in the community, Cafe on the Corner is a restaurant business. We're not in a business district. So we're located in the middle of our community, and we live here. So we're neighbors with our community. And one of the most important things for us was to build economic development within our communities by offering jobs to those in our community. So we wanted to raise up indigenous leaders within our community, because when you give your community an opportunity for work, and you empower and equip them and encourage them, and that all it does is it pours back into the community. And so that's what we feel is the most strengthening of who we are as a family-owned community business, is by giving it back.
Now, I also read that you guys have over 30 years experience working in kitchens worldwide. What was that experience like?
That experience of one of the things that the chef, his name was Chef Gerald Lawrence, after my 2-year apprenticeship, he encouraged me to move about throughout the country and to learn everything that I could possibly learn in the field of cooking and work in all sorts of all kinds of different restaurants. And that's what I set out to do. And my career took me from here, from Pittsburgh. I'm a Pittsburgher, and all the way to California and everything in between. And I became a sous chef. I became a garmanger. I became a broiler chef. I became a saute chef. I became the head chef. So I developed all kinds of different experiences, which brings me to where I'm at today to be able to run my own business.
We'll be right back with the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report.
The Port Authority of Allegheny County is hiring. If you're looking for a long-term career, competitive wages, great benefits, and desire an opportunity where very few days are the same, check out the opportunities at portauthority.org. We are driven to improve transit in the region. That's portauthority.org.
We do all we can to ensure our kids are happy, healthy, safe, and strong. Having high-quality, low-cost health insurance helps make that possible. With CHIP, your child can have medical, dental, eye care, and more for free or low cost. Whether you're self-employed, unemployed, or your employee benefits are just too expensive, CHIP is there for you to help your child be strong. CHIP strong. Apply or renew today at 800-986-KIDS or go to chipcoverspakids.com.
Paid for with Pennsylvania taxpayer dollars.
Looking for cost-effective way to increase your company's bottom line? Look no further than Soul Pit Media. With our award-winning print, internet, podcast, or Soul Pit TV options, we can help your business get to that next level. For more information, call 412-407-7685. That's 412-407-7685.
The future of transit is now, and we are working to improve your ride. Look for bus tracking technologies and other innovations to keep you better informed. Getting around town has never been so easy. PortAuthority.org.
Cancer can kill. But what if the human body could naturally kill cancer? Or if surgeons could master robotics to remove a tumor in a fraction of the usual time? You don't have to imagine it. The treatments that will travel the world tomorrow are happening today at UPMC Hillman Cancer Center. Discover the future of cancer care at upmc.com/happeningtoday. UPMC, life-changing medicine.
We're back with the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report. Sounds like a phenomenal story. And as we all know, the pandemic has really affected a lot of not only people, but businesses. How has the pandemic affected your business?
I'll tell you one thing, Craig. A year ago in March, Cafe on the Corner wasn't doing very well by being located in the residential area and continuing trying to build where we were at. And just due to the economic disparity that it was hard for us to get loans. It was hard for Cafe on the Corner to grow economically because the opportunities was just not there for us. When the pandemic hit, it opened up a lot of the doors. I mean, so many doors. It empowered our community during the Black Lives Matter, everything. What happened is our community began to notice who we were and why we were there. And our community began to support us. Outside of our community, the Black community has taken control, and Cafe on the Corner is on the map.
Wow, that's a real uplifting story, because so many people feel that it was all negative, but that just goes to prove that there is a, as they say, a silver lining behind every dark cloud. Now, I also understand that even during the pandemic, that you still help feed the less fortunate through your Kitchen of Grace program. How did you come up with that program?
Well, Kitchen of Grace is our nonprofit arm from Cafe on the Corner to reach at-risk youth in our community. And when the pandemic struck, we had a decision to make because our once dine-in facility was no longer in operation due to the CDC mandate. And my husband and I decided, we prayed about it. We asked God, what should we do with that space? And what came to us was feed our community. And out of that, we turned our once dine-in facility into a mass distribution site where we feed children and families and elderly who were suffering with food insecurities. And still we have that today. And so we had an outpouring of so much support from the community that allowed for us to put nutritional box lunches together that we were able to distribute over 250 free lunches to our community per day.
Wow, that is very impressive. And it shows how creativity played a major role in just your restaurant surviving.
Yes, yes. Because the community, when they recognized that we were giving it away, they in return wanted to give. They wanted to see other people be able to survive. And out of that, the outpour of our community and our neighbors near and far, they came and they supported. And the doors have then remained open during this pandemic. And we're grateful for our supporters.
Now, I could not have you guys on my show without asking you about your menu. What are some of the go-to dishes that Cafe on the Corner is known for?
Cafe on the Corner is known for chicken, shrimp, and crab meat gumbo over rice with cornbread. This dish has single-handedly almost kept the doors open by itself. We had it in Giant Eagles. We had it in Shop and Save. We had it in some of the private restaurants down in the Strip District. But that dish has been really, our community and the whole entire North Side has embraced that dish. We also specialize in smoked rib, fried chicken wing, baked chicken, barbecue chicken. We do greens with smoked turkey, yams, baked macaroni and cheese, and of course, a selection of all kinds of sandwiches.
Wow, man, my crystal ball just lit up and it said to be expecting a visit from me.
Yes, sir.
Sometime in the very near future.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, I wanted to ask you, what other activities does your establishment offer to the general public?
Well, what we do is we offer a catering, a full-blown catering. We do the backdrops. We do photo booth. We do all kinds of food. If you went to our website, we have a litany of catering items to choose from. We put our soul, our love, 51 years of experience into it, and the catering side of it is just awesome. Receive a catering, 9 times out of 10, you'll have some of our Kitchen of Great youth are participating in it. We bring them along on everything that we do. When you do a catering, you support the entire establishment.
You know, I have to say, maybe I'm biased, but this is one of my favorite interviews so far. And what I'd like to do is to support you in any way that I can. Could you tell our listeners and followers how they can patronize your establishment?
Craig, we just asked any listener under the sound of our voice that you would just come out and support Cafe on the Corner by coming and buying a dish, by allowing us to serve you in our caterings for all events. If you need a catering, we would love to serve you and your guests. We now also offer apparel. So we have t-shirts and mugs and we offer spices. So come on out and support us at 2700 Shaylin Avenue, located on the north side of Pittsburgh.
Now, do you have a phone number or email address also?
Our telephone number is 412-415-3672. And our website is www.cafeonthecornerpgh.org.
Now, since you guys made me so hungry when you said what is on your menu, please repeat all that information one more time because I want to write it down myself and give our listeners and viewers another opportunity to patronize.
Yes, sir. Our number one dish, that is, if you went to our website and if you punched in gumbo without even naming a restaurant, it's going to pop up Cafe on the Corner. It's chicken, shrimp, and crab meat. It's over rice with cornbread. We also do smoked ribs, fried chicken wings, baked chicken, barbecue chicken. We do yams, macaroni and cheese, greens, green beans, fried cabbage, and a litany of sandwiches.
You know, every time you say that, I don't know why, but my crystal ball lights up again. And it keeps saying that for you guys to expect a visit from me in the very near future. Could you please give out your phone number and address one more time?
Absolutely. Cafe on the Corner is located at 2700 Shetland Avenue on the north side of Pittsburgh. You can reach us at 412-415-3672. You can also visit us on our website at www.cafeonthecornerpgh.org.
I want to thank you both for being guests today on the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report. My crystal ball doesn't lie to me, so, you know, you can expect to see me any day now. And thank you guys so much for taking time out of your busy schedule to be on the show today.
Thank you, Craig, for having us.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report.
The Port Authority of Allegheny County is hiring. If you're looking for a long-term career, competitive wages, great benefits, and desire an opportunity where very few days are the same, check out the opportunities at portauthority.org. We are driven to improve transit in the region. That's portauthority.org.
We do all we can to ensure our kids are happy, healthy, safe, and strong. Having high-quality, low-cost health insurance helps make that possible. With CHIP, your child can have medical, dental, eye care, and more for free or low cost. Whether you're self-employed, unemployed, or your employee benefits are just too expensive, CHIP is there for you to help your child be strong. CHIP Strong. Apply or renew today at 800-986-KIDS or go to chipcoverspakids.com.
Paid for with Pennsylvania taxpayer dollars.
Looking for cost-effective way to increase your company's bottom line? Look no further than Soul Pit Media. With our award-winning print, internet, podcast, or Soul Pit TV options, we can help your business get to that next level. For more information, call 412-407-7685. That's 412-407-7685.
The future of transit is now, and we are working to improve your ride. Look for bus tracking technologies and other innovations to keep you better informed. Getting around town has never been so easy. PortAuthority.org.
Cancer can kill. But what if the human body could naturally kill cancer? Or if surgeons could master robotics to remove a tumor in a fraction of the usual time? You don't have to imagine it. The treatments that will travel the world tomorrow are happening today at UPMC Hillman Cancer Center. Discover the future of cancer care at upmc.com/happening today. UPMC, life-changing medicine.
We're back with the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report.
Hi, this is Debbie Norrell, and welcome to the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report Community Calendar. Do you need help installing your child's safety seat? The Pennsylvania State Police will hold a car seat safety check on May 15th from 10 a.m. until noon in Natrona Heights, Allegheny County. Call 412-364-0469 to make an appointment. Space is limited. Shadyside, the other art festival on Walnut Street, takes place in Shadyside with a craft marketplace on May 22nd and May 23rd. Black Urban Gardeners will continue to host the free farmers market at Amplify's Pittsburgh City Campus, 1600 Fifth Avenue, from noon until 3 p.m. on the first and third Tuesdays of the month through June. There will be another at House of Manna in Homewood from 1 to 4 p.m. every second and fourth Friday. Thank you for listening to the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report, brought to you by Port Authority Employment. Looking for a great job with benefits? Check out their website, portauthority.org, and click on Careers. Thank you for tuning in to the Soul Pit Media Health and Business Report, hosted by Craig Dawson, Vice President, Soul Pit Media. Thank you, Pittsburgh, for your continued support.